Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the solution and discussion on the GATE question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. The questions will be from the following four subjects: Thermodynamics, Thermal Engineering, Heat and Mass Transfer, Fluid Mechanics and Machines in my discussion. And this is lecture number 8. The subject is Engineering Thermodynamics. So we will solve the questions from various question paper on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. So this is from 2015 question paper. A well insulated rigid container of volume 1 meter cube contain 1 kg of ideal gas of Cp 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin, Cv 800 joules per kilogram Kelvin at a pressure of 10 to the power 5 Pascal. A stirrer is rotated at constant RPM in the container of 1000 rotations and the applied torque is 100 Newton meter. The final temperature of the gas is in Kelvin is, so we have to fill the blank, calculate the final temperature of the gas, you have to fill the blank. The initial temperature T1 equal to P1 U1 by MR, so from the perfect gas equation. So P1 U1 divided by M into R equal to Cp minus Cv. So P1 equal to 10 power 5 Pascal into V1 equal to 1 meter cube divided by mass equal to 1 kilogram into Cp minus Cv equal to 1000 minus 800 equal to 500 Kelvin. And it is an insulated container. There is no heat transfer. Heat transfer Q equal to 0. The stirring work per kg of the gas. So W equal to 2 pi NT. So 2 into 3.14 into N. Number of rotations 1000. Into 100, so this is equal to 628,000 joules per kilogram, 628,000 joules per kilogram. So from the first law of thermodynamics, so we have Q equal to W plus U2 minus U1. So Q equal W plus delta U, U2 minus U1. So W plus Cv into T2 minus T1. So U2 minus U1 equal to Cv into T2 minus T1. Heat transfer Q equal to 0. So work done we have calculated as 628,000 plus 800 into T2 minus 500. So solving this equation, this T2 equal to 500 plus 785 equal to 1285 Kelvin. So the temperature is 1285 Kelvin. So the final temperature of the gas is 1285 Kelvin. And this is again 2015 question paper. So the work is done on a adiabatic system due to which its velocity changes from 10 meters per second to 20 meters per second. Elevation increases by 20 meter and the temperature increases by 1 Kelvin. So the mass of the system is 10 kilogram. Specific heat at constant volume Cv equal to 100 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second square. If there is no change in any other component of energy of the system, the magnitude of total work in kilojoules on the system is that. So you have to calculate the work done and fill in the blank. So the steady flow energy equation from the thermodynamics steady flow energy equation, m into g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus u1 plus p1 v1 plus q equal to m into g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus u2 plus p2 v2 plus w. And here we are given change in the elevation. You are given change in the elevation 20 meter. Initial velocity is given 10 meters per second. Final velocity is given 20 meters per second. Change in temperature is given as 1 Kelvin. So there is no information about the pressure and volume. So we remove P1 V1 and P2 V2. So because the condition is given, there is no other change in any other component, no change in any other component of the energy. So P1 V1 and P2 V2, they are called as flow energy. So we have to drop the flow energy. Now M into, so P1 V1, P2 V2, they are dropped. Now we have to rearrange. I take Z2 to the left side. So G into Z1 minus Z2. plus 1 by 2 v1 square. We take v2 square by 2 left hand side. So 1 by 2 v2 square minus 1 by 2 v2 square plus cv. u1 is available here and u2 from right to left. So cv into t1 minus t2 equal to w, what is left out in the right hand side. Now you have the value change in elevation, increase in elevation. So it is given as 20 meter. So z2 minus z1 is given as 20 meter. We have z1 minus z2 equal to minus 20. And change in temperature, increase in temperature. So 1 Kelvin, that is T2 minus T1 equal to 1 Kelvin. So T1 minus T2 equal to minus 1 Kelvin. So you substitute here. So mass equal to 10. G is 10. It is given. G is 10 meters per second square. 10 into z1 minus z2 minus 20. So minus of 10 into 20 plus 1 by 2. 10 square minus 20 square minus 100 into 1. So 100 is the CV value. And T1 minus T2 equal to minus 1. So minus 100 into 1. So solving, work done equal to minus of 4500, which is 4.5 kilojoules. So the magnitude of work in the system is 4.5 kilojoules. So the work done is 4.5 kilojoules. A piston cylinder device initially contains 0.4 meter cube of air to be treated as ideal gas. At 100 kilopascal and 80 degree Celsius, the air is now isothermally compressed to 0.1 meter cube. The work done during this process is in Kelvin dash in kilojoules. Take the sign convention such that work done on the system is negative. So this is from the 2016 question paper. So this is isothermal work done, isothermal compression process. For isothermal compression process, W equal to for isothermal process work done equal to P1 V1 into logarithmic of V2 by V1. So P1 is given as 100 kilopascal, V1 is given as 0.4 meter cube into logarithmic of V2 by V1. So V2 final volume is 0.1 meter cube, logarithmic of 0.1 divided by 0.4 equal to minus 55.45 kilojoules. The negative sign is due to the compression work. So for isothermal process, W equal to P1 U1 logarithmic of V2 by V1. So the negative sign indicates it is compression work. So the work done for the compression process minus 55.45 kilojoules. So this is work done on the system. That is why you have a negative sign. Another question from 2016 question paper. Steam at an enthalpy of 100 kilojoules and inlet velocity of 100 meters per second enters an insulated horizontal nozzle. It leaves the nozzle at 200 meters per second. The exit enthalpy is dash kilojoules per kilogram. You have to calculate H2 enthalpy at the outlet. So the steady flow energy equation for per unit mass. So GZ1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 plus Q equal to GZ2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2 plus W. So this is adiabatic nozzle. So insulated horizontal nozzle. For a insulated nozzle, Q equal to 0. Horizontal nozzle Z1 equal to Z2 and there is no work done in the nozzle, W equal to 0. So Q equal to 0, W equal to 0, Z1 equal to Z2. So deleting all the terms, left hand side we have 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 equal to 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2. Substituting. So 1 by 2 V1 square, V1 square equal to 100 meters per second, 100 square plus 100, H1 equal to 100 kilojoules per kilogram. 100 into 1000. So you have to substitute the enthalpy in joules per kilogram here. So multiply by 1000 plus 1 by 2, 200 square plus H2. So solve this equation. We will get H2 equal to 85 into 10 power 3, which is 85 kilojoules per kilogram. So the answer is 85 kilojoules per kilogram. The next question from 2017 question paper. 1 kg of ideal gas. R, gas constant R equal to 400 joules per kilogram Kelvin, CV equal to 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin at 1 bar and 300 Kelvin is contained in a sealed cylinder. During an adiabatic process, 100 kilojoules of work is done on the system by a stirrer. The increase in entropy of the system is dash joules per Kelvin. So you have to calculate change in entropy. For adiabatic process, del Q equal to 0. So we have the first law of thermodynamics, del Q equal to del W plus MCV into T2 minus T1. So as del Q equal to 0, left hand side equal to 0, del W equal to minus 100 into 1000. So converting kilojoules into joules minus 100 into third one, because work is done on the system. So work is done on the system is negative. So minus 100 into 1000 plus MCV, M equal to 1, CV equal to 1000 into T2 minus 300. So T1 equal to 300. So find the T2 equal to 400 Kelvin. For the process, so adiabatic process, sealed cylinder. So adiabatic process, delta S equal to MCV into logarithmic of T2 by T1. This equal to 1 into 1000 into logarithmic of 400 by 300. 400 by 300 equal to 287.68 joules per kilogram. The answer is 287.68 joules per Kelvin. Next problem from 2017 question paper. A calorically perfect gas, the specific heat at constant pressure is 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin, enters and leaves the gas turbine with the same velocity. The temperature of the gas at turbine entry and exit are 1100 Kelvin and 400 Kelvin respectively. The power produced is 4.6 megawatts and the heat escapes to the at the rate of 300 kilojoules per second through the turbine casing. The mass flow rate of the gas in kilograms per second through the turbine is, we have four choices, 6.1, 7 kilogram per second, 7.5 kilogram per second or 8 kilogram per second. We have to calculate the mass flow rate. So using the steady flow energy equation once again, we write the steady flow energy equation, m into g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 plus q equal to m into g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus h2 plus w. So we have, there is no change in the velocity, the velocity is the same, v1 equal to v2, so we can drop the term, and z1 equal to z2, so that is also we have to drop for the turbine. So the deleting z term and the velocity term, so m into h1 minus h2, you bring the h2 to the left side, m into h1 minus h2 plus q equal to w. So this is a gas turbine, so hc enthalpy equal to cp into temperature. So m into cp into t1 minus t2 plus q minus equal to w work done. So m into cp equal to, it is given as 1000 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So I take 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin into t1 equal to 1100 minus t2 equal to 400 minus q. So the heat leakage is 300 kilojoules per second. So minus 300 equal to 4.6 in 10 power 3. So we are given 4.6 megawatts. So 4.6 in 10 power 3. So solving this equation, mass equal to 7 kilograms per second. So the correct answer is 7.0, option B. So 7 kilograms per second. So this is from 2017 question paper. And the question is from 2018 question paper. Steam flows through the nozzle at a mass flow rate of 0.1 kilograms per second with a heat loss of 5 kilowatt. The enthalpy at inlet and the exit are 2500 kilojoules per kilogram and 2350 kilojoules per kilogram respectively. Assuming negligible velocity at inlet, the velocity of the steam at the exit is in meters per second. So we have to fill up the blank. So we have to calculate the velocity and fill in the blank. Again, we take the steady flow energy equation. So m into, for given mass, m into g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 plus q equal to m into g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus h2 plus w. For nozzle, w equal to 0. We are not given z value, horizontal nozzle. So z1 equal to z2. So z1 equal to z2, w equal to 0. And we are given negligible inlet velocity. So V1 is also 0, assuming negligible inlet velocity. So V1 equal to 0. So Z1 equal to 0, V1 equal to 0. In the left hand side, we have M, H1 plus Q. I bring the H2 to the left side. So M into H1 minus H2 plus Q equal to M into 1 by 2 V2 square. So divide by the M throughout the equation. So H1 minus H2 plus Q by M plus 1 by 2 V2 square. Now you substitute the values. So 2500 minus 2350 multiplied by 1000. So the enthalpy values are given in kilojoules per kilogram. We have to substitute in joules per kilogram. So multiply by 1000 minus heat is last heat is leaking, escaping, so it is negative sign. So 5 kilowatt, so 5000 divided by mass equal to 0.1 kilograms per second equal to 1 by 2 V2 square. Now you solve the equation, we will get V2 equal to 447.21 meters per second. So the velocity at the exit of the nozzle is 447.21 meters per second. And this is from the 2019 question paper. A gas is heated in a duct as it flows over a resistance heater. Consider a 101 kilowatt electric heating system. The gas enters the heating section of the duct at 100 kilopascal and 27 degrees Celsius with a volume flow rate of 15 meter cube per second. If heat lost from the gas in the duct to the surrounding at a rate of 51 kilowatt, the exit temperature of the gas is, you have to calculate, we have four options, 37 degrees Celsius, 76 degrees Celsius, 53 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Celsius. We have to take Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and R equal to 0.5 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate the density of the gas at inlet conditions, rho 1 equal to P1 by R into T1. So from the given data, so the 100 P1 equal to 100 kilopascal divided by R equal to 0.5 and the temperature is 327 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. So the density rho 1 equal to 0.67. Mass of the gas flow M equal to rho into V, rho into volume flow rate. So it becomes 0.67 into 50 equal to 10.05 kilograms per second. Now once again we take the steady flow energy equation. M into G Z1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 plus Q equal to M into G Z2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2 plus W. So it is air, the gas is heated to the electrical system. So W equal to 0, Z1 equal to Z2, V1 equal to V2. So there is no velocity change, there is no elevation change. So Z1, V1, Z2, V2, they are dropped and there is no work done, W is also dropped. In the left hand side we have MH1 plus Q equal to MH2. So this is equal to, so this is the gas, so H equal to Cp into T. So MCP T1 plus Q equal to MCP T2. Now you substitute. M equal to 10.05 into Cp equal to 1 kilojoules per kilogram into T1 equal to 300 minus 51. So 51 kilojoules of kilowatts of heat energy is lost to the surrounding minus 51 plus the electrical heating system is 101 kilowatts. So plus 101 equal to 10.05 into 1 into T2. So T2 is the unknown. So solving this equation, T2 equal to 31.975 degrees Celsius or 32.32 degrees Celsius. So the correct answer is 32 degrees Celsius. So this is from 2019 question paper. And once again another question from 1997 question paper. Air enters a frictionless adiabatic converging nozzle at 10 bar 500 Kelvin with negligible velocity. The nozzle discharges to a region at 2 bar. If the exit area of the nozzle is 2.5 cm square, find the flow rate of air through the nozzle. Assume Cp equal to 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 718 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So the answer is 0.3359 kilograms per second. So we will see how. So we take gamma equal to Cp by Cv equal to 1005 divided by 718 equal to 1.4. For adiabatic process, we find the final temperature. So T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So 500 into 2 by 10 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 315.7 Kelvin. So final temperature is 315.7 Kelvin. And we calculate the specific volume at the outlet RT2 by P2. So 0.287, R equal to 0.287, 315.7 divided by 200 kilopascal. So 2 bar is 200 kilopascal equal to 0.453 meter cube per kilogram. Now we take the steady flow energy equation once again. So for the general equation, steady flow energy equation for the nozzle. So converging nozzle, there is no work done. So M into G Z1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 plus Q equal to M into G Z2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2. And we have the condition negligible velocity. Negligible inlet velocity. So V1 equal to 0, Z1 equal to Z2. Now you calculate M. So M is dropped, M is neglected. So Cp into T1, left hand side Cp into H1 equal to Cp into T1, right hand side 1 by 2 V2 square plus Cp into T2. So V2 equal to square root of 2 Cp into T1 minus T2. So 2 into 1005 into 500 minus 315.7 equal to 608.64 meters per second velocity. And the mass flow rate from the steady flow energy equation A2 V2 by small v2. So area velocity divided by the specific volume. So area is given as 2.5 centimeter square. So 2.5 into 10 power minus 4 into 608.64 divided by 0.453 equal to 0.3359 kilograms per second. So that is the answer. So the mass flow rate here 0.3359 kilograms per second. And another question from 2000 question paper. A certain mass of pure substance undergoes an irreversible process from the state 1 to state 2, the path of the process being a straight line on the TS diagram. Calculate the heat transfer and the work done. We take T1 equal to 330 Kelvin, T2 equal to 440 Kelvin, U1 equal to 170 kilojoules, U2 equal to 190 kilojoules, enthalpy H1 equal to 220 kilojoules, H2 equal to 247 kilojoules, entropy S1 equal to 0.23 kilojoules per Kelvin, and S2 equal to 0.3 kilojoules per Kelvin, where T, U, H and S represents temperature, internal energy, enthalpy and entropy. So this is the process line at the TS plane. So temperature in the y-axis, entropy in the x-axis, T1 equal to 330 Kelvin, T2 equal to 440 Kelvin, S1 equal to 0.23 kilojoules per Kelvin and S2 equal to 0.3 kilojoules per Kelvin. So we know that the area of the temperature entropy diagram, it is what the change in heat transfer. So heat transfer, the area under the TS diagram, that is the heat transfer. So area heat transfer equal to area of the TS diagram. So Q12, so heat transfer between 1 and 2 equal to area 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, the triangle area plus area under the rectangle 1, 3. So area under 1, 3. Area of the triangle is half B into H. Half into B. B equal to S2 minus S1. H equal to T2 minus T1. Plus area of this rectangle is temperature T1 into S2 minus S1. So T1 into S2 minus S1. Combining the two terms, this will be 1 by 2 S2 minus S1 plus into T2 plus T1, because we have half of T2 minus half of T1. So you combine T, actually you combine the T1 here, so it will be T2 plus T1. So substituting Q12 equal to 1 by 2, S2 is 0.3, S1 is 0.23, T2 is 440, T1 is 330. So heat transfer equal to 26.95 kilojoules. And the work done for the process using the first law of thermodynamics, heat transfer work done equal to heat transfer minus change in internal energy. So 26.95 minus change du equal to u2 minus u1. So u2 equal to 190 minus u1 equal to 170 is equal to 6.95 kilojoules. So the heat transfer is 26.95 kilojoules and the work done is 6.95 kilojoules. So this is the answer. Heat transfer is 26.95 kilojoules and work done is 6.95 kilojoules, and this is from 2008 question paper. So we stop here. Thank you for watching, and please post your comment on the YouTube comments box. I will improve the presentation. You subscribe the YouTube channel. I have uploaded more than 180 lecture videos on heat transfer, thermodynamics, thermal engineering. It will be useful to you. And I uploaded the gate questions also. If you got any questions, queries, you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp to my number. I will sincerely answer. Thank you for watching once again. We'll meet again.